Dear all, welcome to this new guide dedicated to Adobe Premiere Pro, the ultimate video editing solution to realize unique projects with great effects, motion graphics, and nice transitions with full control. This is included in the Creative Cloud bundle under a subscription plan. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our official website for extra tips, tutorials, news, and great giveaway campaigns. When you open Premiere Pro, its home screen page shows up with all your latest projects made. You can browse for others with Open Project on the left, or go to New Project to start from a new one. In this case, set name, location, and time format to use. You can choose time code to use seconds, or frames to use video frames instead. When you go to OK, the main interface opens, showing several panels according to the workspace chosen on top, from Learning to Libraries. In this video, we will just see the editing one. But if you miss any panel, you can find the full list from the Window tab. At first, your new project does not have any sequence. These sequences are independent pieces of videos you create by combining pictures, videos, and sound files on the timeline. To create one, use Control or Command and N, selecting any ready template from the left to fix video and audio properties easily. You can also switch to Settings to customize these options, choosing Custom on Editing Mode to set your own frame rate under Time Base, Resolution under Frame Size, and Audio Sample Rate. Then go to OK. At this point, you can import your own files by dragging and dropping these from any folder or from the Media Browser panel on the left. All these files imported are shown on the timeline as colored blocks called clips. You can move through time with your mouse wheel and zoom in and out if you hold down the Alt key as well. All visual content, like pictures and video frames, is collected inside video tracks, in pink and blue color respectively, whereas audio content is shown in green color with audio tracks at the bottom. All these files are also listed inside the project panel on the left. You can double-click on any file to check its visual and audio content on the source preview above. Whereas if you want to check the current sequence content, you can use the program window. This shows content where the blue marker is placed in time. So you can click on the timeline or drag it to move such marker and check different frames. To play back all in real time with audio, use the player buttons, adjusting quality with playback resolution. If you find out that the sequence is cutting parts of your video or it is showing black bars, you can right-click on it from the project window and go to Audio Reframe Sequence to resize all automatically. Now let's see how to edit the timeline clips with the editing tools at the bottom and several panels on the left. With the selection tool enabled, click and drag any clip to move it in time or in different tracks. Video frames with audio are always moved together, unless you make these independent by right-clicking on these and going to Unlink. In case clips overlap in time, Premiere shows all clips on the top video tracks in front of all the others placed on lower tracks in position. To adjust any clip length, just drag from its edges. This removes content in case the clip is either a video or an audio file. You can avoid this by dragging edges with the Rate Stretch tool, changing the playback speed instead of cutting content. In this case, you increase or decrease speed by shortening or stretching the clip. Whereas enable the razor tool to split the clip in multiple pieces. You can cut, copy, and paste any selected clip by using Control or Command and X, C, and V. You can cut clips to delete these quickly. To undo, use Control or Command and Z, or the History window on the left. Next to each track, you have several options to manage its content. You can use the I button to hide and show content from any video track, the Mute button to mute any audio track, and the Solo button to mute all the other audio tracks except the current one. You can also enable the Record button to start recording from your microphone on the chosen track, and the Lock button to block modifications on any clip inside it. At the very bottom, you have the Master track, where you can adjust the volume level from the whole sequence. Make sure to avoid red levels from the volume meter that can cause distortion. To remove or add tracks, right-click on any empty space. You can adjust the full properties of any clip by selecting it and going to Effect Controls in the top left corner. Click and drag on values to edit. Use the Reset button to revert these, and the FX button to enable or disable the changes made on any property. These properties shown here change according to the kind of clip chosen. On visual clips, you can adjust position, size, and rotation under motion, and the transparency level under opacity. On sound clips, you can adjust the volume level and the balance between the left and right stereo channels. In addition, you can open the effects window to browse for several visual and audio effects. You can drag and drop on clips directly. These will be added as extra properties you can adjust while checking the preview. From the same list, you also find visual and audio transitions to begin and end clips with nice effects. You can drag and drop any transition on a clip edge or between two clips. This is shown as a simple block with its name that can be moved, stretched, or adjusted in properties, just like other clips. Consider that the longer the transition is, the slower its effect will be. To remove the transition, right-click on it and go to Clear. You can drop pieces of text with the Type tools. Click and drag on the Program window to define the region where the text can spread. Then type in, adjusting text properties, font, style, and color from either the Effects controls or the Essential Graphics window. Moreover, you can use the Selection tool to move, scale, and rotate the text container directly. This piece of text is represented as a pink title clip on the timeline that can be moved and edited just like other clips. Make sure to place it on a top video track to keep it visible over other visual clips overlapping. Besides these basic pieces of text, you can open the Essential Graphics panel to find advanced text templates that include animated text, credit rolls, and subtitles. Under Browse, choose any template and hover over these to get a quick preview. Then drag and drop any on the timeline to import the text clip ready to use. Modifying any of its components from the Edit section above. In addition, you can use the Essential Sound panel to apply advanced corrections to your selected audio clips. First of all, set its correct type between dialogue, music, SFX effects, or ambience, and then use its dedicated options to adjust sound that include audio ducking, equalizer, and reverb control. To save your file, go to File, Save As. This gets saved as a .prproj file that includes all its sequences, clip properties, and placement on the timeline. Whereas to export the final video, select the right sequence and go to File, Export, Media. On the left side, under Source, you can crop the final video or adjust its aspect ratio to match with your footages. At the bottom, you can drag the markers to select which part of the sequence needs to be exported. On the right, set the complete video properties. Select the file format, such as H.264 or MP4, and pick any ready preset, including HD and 4K templates for Facebook and YouTube. At the bottom, you can fully customize the video properties, such as resolution, frame rate, audio format, codec, sample rate, and bit rate. If you are not an expert, you can simply click on the check mark on the right to match the video properties with the source files you are running on the sequence. On output name, click to set video name and destination folder, and then go to export to render your final video. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Check out our dedicated guide to discover more on Adobe Creative Cloud 2021. Completely for free.